Hello. Hello. Hello, my name is Brendan and welcome to Acting Out Origin, your weekly writing web show, now appearing daily for this week only. What's going on, guys? Sorry about the late start. I was playing Myst and got distracted. Because I really wanted to play that game. So yeah. Very interesting narrative wise, but we're going to continue working on the comic today. I think we're going to get it done. Just in the interest of general upkeep, I will, if I have time today, like if I finish this a lot sooner than I thought, I'm going to work on a Drawny story. Because I do need to finish that. Just one or two more drafts, I think would be okay. And then, if I still have time, I'm going to do work on the website. Because that needs to get done. And technically still writing. So that's my plan for today. We'll see. I suspect finishing these last six or so pages is probably going to take the rest of the time, but just in case. Just in case. Because I don't want to start editing it today. I want to save that for tomorrow if it does get done. So yeah. Gonna continue on. Where was I? I was... more pages. Here we keep forgetting things. You're good. It's fine. If someone could let me know eventually if the audio is better today, that would be awesome. There we go. Now we're good. Now, narratively, how do I get out of that scene? Oh, by the way, I did find that thing from yesterday. If anyone was curious what I was talking about. My browser is not handling the new Twitch changes very well. It happens every now and again. I get colorful. I think Derek's light is also pretty blown out most of the time, though it's better in his new house compared to his old one. So, page 16 shows him leaving the castle. Walks down the path. Bushes. Next page, campfire. Nice, Johnny. Page 18 is him visiting the moneylender. So they're back in the city. So I need to figure out how I want to resolve this talking bush situation. Because I kind of feel with the super serialness of Pharaon, he's going to attack the bushes in some way. Kind of ends with them, with him realizing. It's Shroud. Is it just me, or would it be a good plan to swap Pharaon and Shroud's names? Is that a thing? Though I kind of like it, just being weird. fire. I don't super dislike this sort of like what's the plan sort of style thing I have going on here. In fact, I've shown a very a big pattern of repeating things in this comic, like this weird symmetry of, you know, there's two trapdoors and there's two secret entrances. So I don't mind repeating sort of this, like, what's the plan? But I kind of wonder, if it's 100% necessary. I also wonder if I should add some more narration. Because I had some narration on the first couple of pages, right? And I'm wondering if I should have some more. Is Pharaon too stoic? Does he... like, do you understand what he's doing and why he's doing it? Like, I feel like why are they escaping? What are they escaping for? Just to escape? They don't want to die, sure, but there must be a deeper reason for that. We know that Pharaon goes to his money stash. Do we know why he does that? Should this campfire scene be where we reveal that? I mean, that seems like a solid plan. So outside the castle is 16, and then a plan is formed is 17. Meeting the Mudrunner is 18. Did I miscount these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Oh yeah, I did miscount them. This would actually be 18 and 19. There we go. That makes more sense. So 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Feel like it should be 24 pages. And page 24. Yeah, okay. I kind of have an idea. That still stands. Okay. Solid. Feeling like I got a better handle on this now. Whoa, what did I just do? That's cool. That's super cool. Neat. It's 24. That back up. Change this to why is that drawing? Because she's meeting all the people you want to meet, or something. How did I mess this up? What the hell? We are good. Hey man, what's going on? Well, I gotta do that at some point. Fix my Twitter. No, please stay. It's up to you. I'm just working on this comic. And I'm just an awkward person in general. So, I wouldn't say there's any moments that aren't awkward, is what it is. Oh, you mean Jelani? Cause I'm not gonna start crying. That's not happening. It's a fantasy story about an assassin's guild. That is getting disbanded because guards and royalty. It's kind of just a one shot, like seeing where what I can do with the world sort of thing. Just for funsies. I am not entering that competition. Mostly because I don't have time to write a novel right now. I have other stuff to do. But there's another reason, which will be revealed later. I don't know if that's a secret or not. I will wait until told otherwise. Mm-hmm. Well, thank God you can't see my attempts at drawing. Now we do a campfire. Yeah, I want a campfire. Do want a campfire. Okay, I think that's good for that page. It's in my experience, comics are one of the least similar processes from person to person I've ever seen. Screenwriting, the process is fairly straightforward. Like, most people do around the same thing. Formatting's the same. Novels, the process can vary, but it's not a terrible difference. For novels, mostly I find that the planning stages are really where people differ. And then the actual, like, writing process, like what they write and when, not really the actual act of writing. Comics, it depends entirely on who you are, who your team is, what you like, what you don't like. Like, for example, if I'll go back to the example of the archives from the beginning of the week. We go back to this, with Jim Zub, who I'm a huge fan of. Yeah. So it's like, he makes a pacing page, what he wants to happen in the issue, what where they kind of happen. He writes out the script, he sends it off to the artist draws the pencils, he sends it to the letterer puts in the dialogue and all that. Then he tweaks things, sends it back, stuff like that. And this is just one of a thousand ways to do it. There is a very famous method called the Marvel method because Marvel Comics started it back when Stan Lee was their editor-in-chief and their head writer and all that, where he literally wrote outlines for every issue. He'd like write like a general outline of like what he wanted to happen, and then he'd write dialogue for each page, and he'd just give it to the artist, and the artist had to plan everything themselves. Some people really like that. Not everyone does. I was talking about it a little bit earlier in the week as well. It's a great book, by the way. But there's an interview with artists here on these pages here, and they talk about what they want from a script. Most of them prefer full scripts, a couple of them don't. And like what they like out of actual scripts. The most important thing is communication. How you communicate with your artists is the most important thing, and how they communicate with you. Generally, you write a script and then the artist draws it. That's the general gist. That being said, if you're into screenwriting, screenwriting is not that different. I personally think that the jump from novels to screenwriting is much, much larger than the jump from screenwriting to comic scripts. Mostly because when you're already thinking in that visual language, pulling out individual shots out of a sequence is not as difficult as going from that huge prose showing internalization to working entirely with visuals. You tell stories differently. And that's not to say that you tell stories exactly the same way in comics as you do in film. It's just that when you're thinking in a visual language versus thinking in a descriptive language, it's different. And I know that for sure because I actually studied screenwriting in college. Like, that's what I did. And I definitely think that the links between that and prose, the links between screenwriting and comics is much, much similar. In fact, I would make an argument that going from screenwriting to playwriting is a bigger leap than going from screenwriting to comic scripting. But that might be just me and the way that my brain works. this is going to be. That is a shame. See, in my class, we didn't touch on prose or poetry, but we did everything else on that list. We didn't talk a lot about graphic novels, but we did a little bit. And we talked about games only a little bit. Only as a tool of expanding on a previously established concept and working on the internet. Not really like writing games specifically. More so like, you know, if you're proposing a television show, what kind of games would you propose to go with it? If it was like a kid show or interactive experiences that might improve their online experience, stuff like that. As well as writing for the web in general. I think this is going to be the first set of talking heads we've had, which is good, because I don't think it's something that you have to cut entirely. It's just you shouldn't have it all the time. Especially because I haven't spent that much time actually working on dialogue specifically. A lot of empty panels with action. But that's mostly because I'm such a huge fan of the decompressed style. Do I doodle as I write? I'm actually working on I mean, I kind of do, but I'm actually working on thumbnail sketches for like how I want the panels and all that to look. I find it really helps me visualize what I'm doing and pacing and stuff. Like, this is what I'm working on right now. So I do doodle while I write, but it's actually more because I'm thinking visually more so than actually just doodling. Right, I suppose. I call it thumbnailing because that's the official term for it. And this is also like stuff I could scan and send to my writer if I needed to. Or to my artist. Sorry. How long am I going to stream? I'm going to be streaming until 10 after 3 Eastern Standard Time. I only do 3-hour streams. I rarely do less than 3 hours. Well, actually, I rarely do less than 2.5. But... No, I'll still be here unless you're going to be a super long time. It's all good. No problem. I'm happy to answer questions. Have a good trip, though. Oh, yeah, that's fine. I hadn't done anything really. Only thing I did was add a wide shot tag on the previous page. Because I thought it might be better. Yep, I'm gonna have dialogue here. I just haven't decided what I want for dialogue yet. What did I call that guild? Oh, Grimguard. That's what I wanted. How many words is this? Perfect. 26 words? That's perfectly acceptable. All right. Window. Just found an intriguing set of articles on Lit Reactor, which is a great place to get writing resources about writing comics, because I was looking for specifically the general average of recommended words per panel and page, which I believe is 25 and 250, if I'm not mistaken. Not in terms of the script, in terms of like dialogue. Yeah, 25, 200. That makes sense. That's fine. Not putting it up. It's not worth it. I just was curious, but it's pretty much what I thought it was, so no worries there. But I am going to take a 5-minute break, so I will see you all in 5 or so minutes.
We'll be right back. Remember the fade in your eyes. I'm lost in space, floating away. Oh, why? Oh, why? Oh, why? I'm running away.
And I'm coming back. Alright. So I can delete this. Thank you. Do I want Farron to show Shroud the sack? Is that something I want to do? I'm not sure if that's something I want to do. To be honest, I have no idea. I thought I did. I definitely thought I did. I wonder if the new format changed a few things. Did that work? Hey, Nerdalicious. Welcome back. I'll have to look at it after, Johnny. I think that's all I want there. That should be good. I think we're good. Helicopter. Super weird.
Oh, well, I think it's gone. Odd things are happening. Odd things are happening. So yeah, I need to set up again kind of what this city looks like.
downhill here. Same shot. Say go now. This would be like, thinking kind of like Assassin's Creed-esque, where there'd be, or even like ancient Greek houses, where there'd kind of be like a door, and then inside the door there's like a hallway. And then there would be like, it'd be like, oh, not like a hallway, but like a small entranceway, and then there'd be like a bit of a garden, and then apartments, sort of thing, almost like an apartment building, I guess, would be more accurate. This is page 20. So this would be kind of like a building. They're looking out. There's guards in the background. Everyone's here. Same shot. They walk across. Let's enter the door. Four. Yeah, I think this is going to be more like a 7. Seven panels, I think, would be ideal here. Sounds about right. Nothing like having good reference. Pinterest, yuck. Not getting what I want. Oh well, it's fine. So we're really looking tough, guys. Four, five, six panels. Kind of getting into the flow here, making progress. I forgot the panels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is that what I said? Yeah, probably better. Sure. Okay, yeah, so I want to change this. I want to do this to be called the city. Take this, move it to here. Take all the text from that one, put it in here. Mark this one as done. Mark this one as not done. Now we're good. Why is that drowning? Though I do agree with you. The one thing I was kind of annoyed about yesterday was I can't set up Twitch to jump straight into a creative category. Like into a creative community. You can only follow straight creative. So I can't just like jump into writing. Which is really unfortunate. Oh, I see what you mean. Well, that's true. I am being creative. I hope I'm being creative. Could be wrong. I've been wrong before. Change the description I had on here. It happens. A divan is a type of couch, particularly an old style one. It looks like this. This is a divan. Yeah, I wouldn't really consider those. This kind of thing. It's like a fancy bench couch. Do I want him eating grapes? Nah, that's too much. That's too stereotypical. What should his name be? What should our moneylender's name be? Fat Louis. I'm not calling him Fat Louis. It's not happening, drawing. Good try, though. big one. More of a smaller panels. It's like guy on couch. And then Farron hands him, holds out the sack. I'm okay with that, Drani. You always associate names weirdly, so yeah. That's another panel here. 3, 4, 5. I feel like I'm doing a lot more panels. Few pages than I was doing before. It's weird. Figure out. So I don't have that many pages left, so I can't push it too much. Oh, but I already planned for this. Excellent. I'm smarter than I thought. I don't have to do. Yeah, okay, I have an entire other page. So yeah, I think there's good. I don't want to really do any more. Cool. Yeah, we're gonna go with that. Four panels. Getting real close, guys. Guys and gals. Getting real close. Three pages to go. And I know exactly what page 24 is going to look like. So that's great. You're right. Stop correcting my grammar, Ronnie. No, that's cool. I appreciate it. Continued here. Change this up a bit. Let's put that in there. And take up this action here. Cool. That's another page you just done. That flowed out of me. No problem. 2, 3, 4. Did you? No, I hadn't seen that drawing. Sorry. I had you in the background. So you kind of just blended in. I was lurking. I was doing stuff. Well, I'm going to take another 5-minute break, and then I'll finish up these last two pages. We'll see how long that takes. I suspect it won't take very long at all, in which case I may actually get to working on that story for Drani after all. That could definitely happen. Depends. I have a solid idea for page 24, so it just depends how long it takes me to finish up. Page 23, and then do a quick compile and check to make sure that I didn't miss anything, like formatting stuff, be real quick, because I want to do that, not heavy editing or anything, just checking some formatting, and yeah, see how it goes. But that's the plan. So 5-minute break, I'll see y'all in a bit.
Like the attention, girl, I know you. But you're everything I want in life. Yeah. We're fighting danger like Kung Fu. The love I feel is deep inside. The others don't matter. It's honestly us against the world. We're the perfect team. You're my dream, and I just want it. If you ever need a helper, hey, you should know that I'll be there day and night. Nobody else can love you better. I'm here just to treat you right. You're the reason I'm alive. You're the only pain I can endure. And when you're not here,
all right, here we go. Let's do this. Man, all these changes to Twitch. Messing with my chat and stuff. Bit of a weird struggle. Good job. Not really. I don't think it's terrible. Because all the things that was on the profile was basically what's on your info, right? But I can see it is a little weird. I don't know. So yeah. go for a classic. So here's the question. Here's my question for right now. Do I want to detail out exactly what this fight looks like, or would I prefer to save it for the writer? Or for the artist, I mean, because I'm the writer. Like, say I want to detail out a fight scene of approximately 3 panels or so. It's a good question, and if I do want to leave it for the artist, how do I do that? What's the best way to format that properly? Any suggestions? So I was wondering, Ronnie, about whether or not I should actually detail out the fight scene or not. Do I want to detail out the fight scene, or should I just leave it and leave it for the artist to come up with something cool? Like, just have the sort of beginning and end of the fight sequence. So I'm kind of on the fence. Did I drop? Yeah, I think I had a little bit of a lag spike there. Because my drop frames look like they almost doubled. I agree and disagree, Johnny. I agree with you in a certain sense where, like, I could describe it out. And that might be fine, but it's the other thing is that maybe I don't know if my personal panel breakdown for the fight sequence is going to be strong enough and would probably need to be changed anyway. But, I mean, in the first draft, I could leave it and then maybe detail it out later if I really wanted to. Right? This is just the first draft. It doesn't have to be the final version, right? So it depends. It depends what you're looking for. I guess. I'm gonna leave it like this for now, and I will come back to it during the edit, and I will think about it overnight and then come back to it, because I'm not sure. I'm honestly not sure. Thank you. I think that's it. I think we did it. Compile this bad boy. Take a look. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. So formatting the first. So I fixed that header because it was annoying. There we go. Got it. Off panel, sound effects. Caption, sound effects. Might want to change some options. To not split panels over multiple pages. But that's a small detail. Again, I'm not really doing editing here. I just wanted to double check formatting. Make sure I didn't miss anything. Not sure how I want to do this formatting, but I think for now it's okay. Cool. We are good. We are good. So, how much time do I have left? About 40 minutes. So, I have two options. The first option is I could work on drawing a story. And why does my computer keep doing this? It's so annoying. Oh, whoops. Very, very odd. Anyway, so that's the first option. The second option is I see that Erica Drayton has a 500 word writing challenge that's due today that I could maybe do. See that thing? God, that's annoying. I literally just saw it. So yeah, on the hitchhiker. Almost thought I lost it. All So let's print this. Let's print this and then blow it up so it's actually visible. All right, gonna mute my mic for a sec. I know. I was muted on purpose so you couldn't hear my printer, which is loud and obnoxious. I said that I was muting. You weren't paying attention again. Kappa. I only find it funny because you, like, I say something and then you literally ask me, like, what I just said. It's like... Phrase here. So I like the first two sentences there. Yeah, I saw that. Not control shift save. Thank you. Yeah, I knew that. I mean, fair enough. I remember hearing her mention it. What's the name for no, not that kind of whirlpool. Oh yeah, they call them maelstroms. Spelled that wrong. Cool. I don't like the and there. Fair enough. It is what it is. I love that, but it's better. I need a word for darted. Because I already used darted. That's better. Much, much better. That's probably better. Thanks, man. This is for Drawny's art project. She needed some text to lay into the fake journal she's illustrating. So I agreed to work on it. Well, she did me a solid last time when I needed an illustration for my cover, so fair is fair. Fair is fair. Be weird if she called it a fish. I think he'd call it a fish. Creature. Beast. Beast might be better. Do you have a link to the updated one, Drawny? That I can show off? Yeah, I've been thinking about it because, like, I was thinking of making it feel more old-timey, but I don't really like writing like that. Or I don't think I'm good enough to write like that. I don't have enough experience with the slangy. I've tried and made it as C-like as I could, like, you know, in the way that he describes things. But I don't know. Yeah, we haven't that is the one thing though, we haven't 100% decided on what to call them. No, unfortunately, it's not legit. That's your answer for everything, Johnny. So that's the illustration there. It's coming along. You made a lot of improvements last night, Johnny. These guys are still a little sketchy, but I feel like you're gonna do them kind of last. As well as I'm not sure what this scribble is about. So we'll have to see. Fair enough. I'm just gonna leave it with the square brackets for now, so then I know I need to replace it. That's true, man. I was having that conversation with a friend of mine last night where, you know, getting there, putting in the work, putting in the time. Not quite where I want to be yet, but get there. That's true. Fair enough. The old ruins cover. Super cool. Yeah, it's a weird post-apocalyptic thing. About technology. I think I'm calling him the boy. Fair enough. I love Beowulf. And we read that in high school. I had took an English literature class in high school. There was only 12 of us in the class. It was super awesome. We did stuff like Dante's Inferno and like Marlowe, who's a contemporary of Shakespeare, and like the original version of the Changeling play and stuff like that. Like a lot of mythology and the Aeneid and cool stuff. Anyway, my teacher was actually graduated with a degree in English literature and could read Old English. So he actually read us the first chapter of Beowulf in the original language, which was super interesting. Came back up. Yeah, it was super awesome. The other real cool part about that class was every Monday, we had a university professor come in and give us a lecture on the book that we were reading. Maybe it wasn't every Monday. Maybe it was every second Monday. Anyway, something like that. It was awesome. It was super, super cool. One of the best courses I ever took in high school. Was Beowulf Old English or Middle English? English or Middle English? It's in Old English. That messed things up. There should be another exclamation mark. There we go. So I'm just about where finish this. So I'm gonna finish. I'm gonna finish editing this before I leave, because we're just about at the end of the time. So in terms of English, we speak modern English. The original form was Shakespeare is actually one of the founders of early modern English, which was just being spoken around his time. He actually created a lot of words that ended up in the English language by himself, because he used to just make things up all the time. I think the contractions are not good here. I'm gonna take them out. I think it sounds more old-timey without contractions. Yeah, no problem, man. I'm nearly done, so I'll be ending in a few minutes. So just this last line. I don't like this last line. I need a good ending for this. No, I refuse to put that in running. Because I don't see a fisherman. This is what I was talking about last time. I can't logically figure out A, why he would make that connection. That's like saying, like, for me, it's like, if you got attacked by a fish, would you suddenly be reminded that you killed the fish's family? No, you're a fisherman, you fish. I don't see it. And I know why you have all that stuff. It's because you want to make the mermaid, mer creature into a good guy. Right, but does he, but my point is he doesn't see it as more than an animal. Why would he? He doesn't know about their culture or them as a people. He sees it in the water, he catches it. I don't know. Like, I can't figure out the logic that would make sense. Maybe. I don't buy it though. We can have a discussion about this later. Let me close up the show. And We'll let it sit. Save this second draft. Perfect. All right. No, like, we'll talk about it, okay? We'll talk about it. So yeah, that's gonna be it for me today, guys. I will be back tomorrow at 12 p.m. Eastern to do editing. I will edit the comic book draft. So yeah, I'm not sure how long that's gonna take. I might work on this project for Johnny a little bit more. Maybe I'll do a short writing exercise or something if I have extra time. We'll see how it goes. So yeah, other than that, my name is Brendan. This is Accidental Origin, your weekly writing web show, now appearing daily for this week only. You can follow me on Twitter at FreakLabMishaps, or you can check out the website below. It's still under construction right now, but I should have that stuff finished up by the end of the week. So yeah, thanks for hanging out with me, guys. Appreciate it. Have a good one.